the Academy of Music on 14th Street, New York City. There's boxing, and this Monday night will feature Chico Rollins of New York City and Steve Hayward of Baltimore, Maryland. Boxing every Monday night at the Academy of Music. Now, the next boxing show here in the Garden, Friday, November the 20th, Len Matthews will meet Willie Towie. And on the 27th, November the 27th, Billy Hunter will meet the hard-punching Argentinian, here he is, Alex Mitek. Here is the junior welterweight champion of the world, Alex Ortega. Ladies and gentlemen, the ring officials have been assigned here by the New York State Athletic Commission. The judges are Frank Forbes and Jack Gordon. The timekeeper is George Bannon. Counting for the knockdowns, Morris Goodman. Your referee for the main event, Al Burrow. 10 rounds. From Havana, Cuba, wearing black trunks, weighing 146, Florentino Fernandez. He's wearing white trunks, weighing 147, Gaspar, Ortega. Main event, 10 rounds, another bout to follow.
All right, both white trunks here before you know the rules. You enter a knockdown, the man scoring the knockdown of well in a neutral corner. The man knocked down must take an 8 count. Three knockdowns in 1 round terminates the bout right there. All right, shake hands now, good luck.
Ortega in the white trunks and white shoes, the Cuban, Florentino Fernandez, unbeaten, terrific puncher. He's a welterweight, but he has a upper body development of a heavyweight, wears a 17 collar. Immense shoulders, tapering down to narrow hips. Both are young men. Well, the Cuban was forced to hold on at the end of that rally. Beautiful rally with 1 minute gone by here in a 10-round fight. Bristling fight. Of a 10-rounder coming your way from Madison Square Garden, the Gillette Cavalcade of Sports. Ortega, bobbing and weaving, acts as if he has a lot of respect for the Cuban,
In their first fight, he sort of discounted the Cuban's punching ability, but tonight he's not taking too many chances and boxing beautifully. Jabbing nicely. Got the Cuban swinging wildly. That's the end of round one.
Announcing a completely new razor, the Gillette Adjustable Razor. See this micrometer adjustment? You turn to any one of nine different settings to match your skin and beard. Much as you change the blade exposure on a carpenter's plane, you control the blade edge on the sensational new Gillette Adjustable Razor. Is your beard light? Heavy? Your skin tender? Here's the answer, the only answer. And it's so easy. You're in for clean shaves, the most comfortable shaves of your life, just as close as you want them. The Gillette Adjustable loads and unloads in a jiffy. Try this amazing razor on our positive money-back guarantee. A nearby store has the 195 Gillette Adjustable Razor with dispenser of Gillette Blue Blades and handsome travel case for only $1.95.
Fernandez trying to solve this style. Ortega's fighting differently, did the last time. A very shifty, elusive target. Ortega's a KG veteran, even though he's only 24 years old. He's had 69 fights. This is his 70th fight. Fernandez going for the body now. Getting mad. Fernandez losing his head here, flailing away wildly. Beautiful fight, full of action. Excitement. Let's take a look at this great Cuban. Here is is a tremendous fighter, although right now his nose is as red as the red ring light behind him. He's been catching quite a few, but he is a terrific fighter. He's 23 years old. He's had 21 fights, he won all 21, and he scored 18 knockouts. Boy, they finished at the bell there and kept everybody. His name is Bowie the Ox. That's his nickname. He comes from San Diego, one of 11 children. He worked as a gardener. When his family moved to Havana, he decided to make boxing his career. Eugenio Ruiz was in his corner, and Nick Corby is his manager. Ruiz took him under his wing, switched him from a southpaw to orthodox style. His hobby is baseball. The ring record book shows 21 fights, 21 victories, 18 knockouts. He's a ninth-ranking welterweight. He lost his head there in the second round because he was getting slapped around, and he began to flail away wildly. In the black trunks, Ortega in the white trunks. The third round of a 10-rounder. In their first fight, it was stand and slug. Tonight, Ortega is boxing.
Hard to shave beards. Twist the dial and you control the blade edge angle and edge exposure. And you get shaving comfort that's remarkable. You change blades in less than an instant. Get the new Gillette Adjustable plus dispenser of blue blades, only $1.95.
We've got a very exciting crowd here tonight. Rival cheering sections standing up, waving at each other. in good spirits and a good fight. Florentino Fernandez in the black front. Gaspar Ortega in white. Not jabbing as frequently as he did in the first fight. Throwing more looping punches. Trying to invite a lead, waiting to counter with a right. Beautiful left jab by Florentino. Another nice right jab. Now he's got it working. He's been a little wild up to now. Ortega a little more accurate in his punching. Gaspar Ortega, he's a bobbing, weaving boy tonight and a very clever boxer, and of course he's calling on all the skills he learned in 70 fights against this comparative raw novice. He was a cowboy and he aspired to be a bullfighter not too long ago. He was the top ranking welterweight contender. He's now rated number 10. He was born in Tijuana. He now lives in Mexicali. He's a full-blooded Zapoteco Indian. He's six brothers, three sisters. Four of his brothers are fighters. He sold newspapers, shined shoes, rode horses, likes music, dancing, fishing, and baseball. He's a lieutenant in the Mexican Reserve. Had a brief fling as an amateur, won all eight of his fights, and then turned professional. He twice lost to champion Don Jordan by split decisions by 1 point. Jordan, of course, is the current champion. Jimmy Stinson, the banker, and Nick Corby are his co-managers. His son Miguel was born in Hollywood the same night he fought Kid Gavilan at Wrigley Field. And Florentino's mother, Dahlia, is watching this fight tonight in Havana. 1 minute to the end of round five. Your Gillette Cavalcade of Sports coming your way from famous Madison Square Garden in New York City. A fair night, 50 degrees.
Nothing beats the refreshment you get with a shaving cream shave. See? Gillette Foamy Instant Lather. Just a touch and there's rich, creamy lather that drenches your beard, softens your whiskers. Shaving is fast and easy. And you get that clean, clean feeling only a shaving cream shave can give. Here's a Foamy exclusive. K34, the antiseptic that kills harmful facial bacteria. Regular Foamy or Foamy with menthol added, 79 cents. Or the giant economy size, 98 cents.
Came roaring over and ran right into a sharp, crushing right, right on his chin. A very short punch. Didn't photograph as excitingly as these wild, flailing blows of his, but it was a good, neat, pinpointing right. And that stopped that rally. Fernandez has been looking to his corner there for instructions. Occasionally, you'll notice him swinging his head around. News, New York, where Norman Rothschild will present two towering heavyweights, Mike DeJohn and Charlie Powell. Has a 37-7 record and stopped 26 rivals. So next Friday, Norman Rothschild at War Memorial in Syracuse presents Charlie Powell, Mike DeJohn on your Gillette Cavalcade of Sports. Bobby Pena of Mexico defeated Tony DiBiase of Astoria. Obdulio Nunez TKO'd Tony DiCola. And Babe Simmons of the Bronx beat Tom Kelly of the West Side. To the end of round seven. It's a 10-round fight. The Cuban is still bombing away. Remember, while he doesn't look too smooth, he's a terrific puncher in against a good, slippery, sharp-shooting boxer.
Through the famous butter test. There's the smear of butter. First, we'll take an ordinary pen. See it skip over the butter? Now, the all-new Paper Mate Holiday. See? Guaranteed not to skip. So get the all-new Paper Mate Holiday, complete with Jumbo Texas Refill.
And that means big, son.
Just $1.79 at stores everywhere.
The all-new Paper Mate Holiday Pen writes again and again and again and again.
Thank you.
Gillette has been asked to bring you the following public service message. There was a time when many different health and welfare services made many separate appeals. Then the idea was introduced to organize one campaign for the whole family of services. Millions of Americans saw that this was a sensible way to collect for the community. This is the United Way. Now more than 2,100 communities each have one campaign for child care, the aged, youth organizations. Many United Way campaigns also include the Red Cross, the USO, and medical research into the cause and cure of killer diseases. The United Way serves everybody, delivers your dollars where they're needed most, helps more people, saves more lives. Join your neighbors and give your fair share. Give once. Give the United Way. Cuban punches are landing harmlessly on the elbows, the back, the shoulders. He doesn't wait for an opening. He just throws a punch and hopes for an opening.
Have you taken my razor again?
No, I've got my own. I packed yours. You've forgotten your plane leaves at noon.
Yes, but I'd like to shave before I leave, especially with my new Gillette adjustable.
Well, there it is, darling.
Thank you.
How are you fixed for blades?
There's a husband and wife situation. You know, the new Gillette adjustable razor instantly adapts itself to any beard, any skin.
The most comfortable shave that I've ever had in my life.
Most of the fastidious women I know rely on Gillette to protect their loveliness.
So fast, so clean. Lather, a few gentle strokes, and you're all finished.
Lovely lady, don't forget, protect your loveliness with Gillette.
Get the Gillette adjustable with blue blade dispenser and travel case, only $1.95.
minutes in the fight. Adjustable razor. Users tell us they never had so much comfort in their lives. And that's exactly the reason the Gillette adjustable was invented. Gillette scientists are constantly striving to make shaving as fast and easy as possible. The Gillette adjustable does exactly that. Here's how. There's a micrometer dial on the handle of the Gillette adjustable with numbers from 1 to 9. You set this dial to any one of these 9 positions for 9 different degrees of edge exposure and angle. At the lower numbers, you expose less blade. Comfort never before possible. That's guaranteed, or your money back. See the Gillette adjustable at a nearby store. The razor, dispenser of Gillette blue blades, and handsome travel case cost you $1.95. Well, Johnny Addy has gone over to the right now and checking the cards for the Boxing Commission. A very important fight. On the right corner of the ring, you'll see Dan Dowd, Frank Morris, Jimmy Riccio of the Boxing Commission, and they're checking the cards, and while they're doing that, we'll give you the results of the earlier fights here tonight. Bobby Pena of Mexico defeated Tony DiBiase of Astoria. That was an upset. Abdulio Nunes of Puerto Rico won on a TKO over Tony DiCola of Brooklyn. The referee stopped that, and the crowd booed. Babe Simmons of the Bronx defeated Tom Kelly of the West Side, and Benny Gordon and Tony Santana boxed a draw.
Judge Frank Forbes scores at 6-2 and 2 even. Favor of Fernandez. Judge Jack Gordon has it 5-4, 1 even, Fernandez.
Sharp punching against wild hard punching, and people give different values to different ways of scoring points. This is a scientific game of skill, and there are different values for different approaches. Fernandez unquestionably is the harder puncher. Ortega fought the headier fight and, of course, was sharper and more accurate in his punching. Next Friday, from War Memorial Auditorium in Syracuse, New York, Gillette presents a 10-round heavyweight bout between Charlie Powell and Mike DeJohn. Our associate director, Bob Andrus. Our technical director, Jim Davis. Directed by...